What's up? Welcome to the Pitter Patter stream. Today is going to be making pitter patter noises with the rain, which is looking pretty good to start. This is like some intense rain here. High density, high speed, high angle. We can play with all that. Yes, what's up, Pedro? Congratulations once again. Pedro got his PhD. So do I have to call you Doc now? Do I have to call you Dr. Pedro? Pitter patter, pitter patter! Sound effect time! Pedro the mad scientist, that's what we're gonna call you. Oh, it's a master's of, is that what that stands for? Masters of Science? So give me Dr. Weird. Ruining my headcanon? What's a headcanon? Okay, so we want some pitter patter noises. I'm gonna start with some free sound searching. Should have logged into free sound before I started the stream. I like the way free sound remembers everything you've downloaded so you can remember who to credit. So what I'm doing here is I'm searching their sound effects and looking for ones that are, you know, royalty free, and basically you just note the person's name and later you can go back and thank them and say, hey, I used your sound effect in my game. It's pretty cool. That's called the attribution license, I think. I don't even understand the exact part, the exactness of it all, but anyways. Rain. Heavy rain, rain on windows. Light rain in my yard. Sometimes it helps to turn down your sound on this side. Headcanon. Ooh, that's a, ooh. That could work. Oh, cannon hat? You really awesome. What's up, Silly Billy Bear? Well, let's listen to a little bit more rain, too, before I make my call. Oh, it's a big file. Oh, really? Oh, I never knew this. Headcanon. Starting to get it. You're a master now. So do we have to call you Master Pedro? Because you mastered... You're a master scientist engineer. That's so awesome. How's it going with the job search, man? What's going on there? Master Pedro, you got it, man. Master Engineer Pedro. You're MEP. MEP for short. That's too uniform. I want some pitter patter. Give me some pitters and some patters, please. Maybe this one might be pitter pattery. Oh, this one is pretty pitted battery, but it's very windowy. Too windowy. It might work for inside a cave. No. Yeah, if you took away some of this, this actually might work for inside the cave. If I take away some of the higher end of it. Let's try that. A link. Account.keymailer. Promote your game to audience of millions. Huh. This looks, man, interesting. Huh. This might be a good thing here. I like that it's a tool, not really a service. I hate all these new service businesses. Cool, I'll check this out. I'm opening this in my browser on my iPad so I can remember to check it out later. Back to Twitch chat. Done. Thank you, Master Pedro. How about this heavy rain? It is pretty heavy. But it's very, very the kilohertz of that, you know what I mean? The frequency of that one is really high. It's very foreground. Okay, this is Pleb Nat, as in plebeian. Is that what that stands for? Okay, I guess I have to try this in the game. I can't really tell if this is gonna work. If I take up my idea here is to take a whole bunch of little tiny clips of rain, and make them kind of like little pitter patter noises. Maybe eight. Yeah, let's go for eight different noises. And then whenever a single raindrop lands on the ground, I want to play one of those randomly. So they're gonna be very kind of quiet noises. So, but I'm thinking that we'll add a really nice ambiance that will create rain everywhere. Plebeian, huh? Nice. Okay, so I can't really tell if this kind of rain will work, or maybe this kind of rain might work better. So I'm gonna try a few noises first to test it out. Okay, first thing, I should process the sound first a bit. First of all, don't want it to be stereo. Convert sampling. And the way I like to do mono lately is to not mix the two channels together to make 50-50, because sometimes you can get some noise cancellation that way that you wouldn't want. So I usually use just the left channel or the right channel. And I already know that I don't like some of these higher noises, so I'm gonna play around with the EQ on this a bit. I wish this thing got. I freaking wish. I, you know what? Maybe. Oh. Yeah. I'm gonna edit this up in. No. God damn. It's so nice to use Ableton to make to EQ with. Huh. Think I'm just gonna do a test first here in Audition. Oh yeah, I showed it a couple times here. Let me show you. I haven't finished it yet. This is just, it's, I'm still in the process of making it. This is, you know, the next day, 2 days. So this is some really fast moving, dense rain, you know, coming at a high, you know, a fast angle and all that too. So this is a lot of rain. But it can go anywhere. You can have a soft or a rain. You can have, you know, I'm playing with the colors. I'm playing with the darkness, the shadows, and all that, and the effects when they land. I'm gonna add ripples too. So that's I'm gonna do that on today's stream, where when the whenever a raindrop lands, it can possibly do a ripple if there's some water there. And yeah, I'm making the sounds first right now. Sean is crazy. Congratulations, you got free parking. So what sucks about Audition's EQ is that you can't see what you're actually doing. There's no spectrum analyzer with it. And the spectrum analyzer in this thing sucks. But anyways, I think what needs to change in the sound is to play with the upper end and reduce it a bit. It's I to my what I'm thinking that's wrong with this sound is this 1K to 2K, 3K range, and maybe some of the 4K and above range too. So I'm gonna go ahead and use one of these first. Yeah, let's take it all the way from 1K. Hear that? There's so much noise outside. I think this sounds better though. I can't take this noise. Jesus. What's up, Zanger? Yo! Yo! It's like way better. That's all at -16. Feels so much better. Okay, cool. Apply. I could make that sound better in Ableton, but I think this is good enough to experiment with first. What I'm doing here is I'm creating eight individual droplet sounds, pitters, patters, and then I'm going to combine them all randomly at runtime to create a to try and create rain without it being set to a loop. I want to try it without a loop to see if I can create an actual procedural audio type thing in a very simple way. So, you know, without having to create any actual procedural audio, I guess this technically is procedural audio. You're using eight different effects. You can play whatever. No. I kind of want to get his clip without so much little snappiness. It's like. Actually, those snaps do sound pretty good as pitters and patters. I'm only hitting negative 33 right here. Let's see if we smooth this sound out a bit. If it sounds... Ooh, I think I want it to fall off a different way though. Fall off like that. No, no, no. That's too little ambience. How about just a straight fade out? Nope, a little bit curved up. Yeah, that kind of is a nice combination of the ambience, the ambient like rain and the little, just a single pitter. Okay, so we're going to call this one pitter or patter. This is a pitter. Pitter. Simple. I love simplicity. We need at least a patter. That one does sound like a patter. It's total patter. Very clearly a patter right here. Dude. Did they have to pick right now for doing all this, like... Can you guys hear the blower outside? There's a blower. All right. Happy dinner time. Yeah, that's a nice patter. Patter one. So I'm going to my common sound effects-y stuff. Just gonna call this rain. Zero is gonna be pitter. One's gonna be patter. And then we go pitter patter pitter patter pitter patter. If it works. So, oh, we gotta play it too. Hold on. I was like, yeah, that's gonna work, totally. We need to play sound. In here, whenever a raindrop bounces or flattens itself, it's gonna play a sound. Profile, you have profile component in here? You should have profile, yeah, profile get. Okay, common, play sound. Rain. Pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter. So the sounds are at negative 33 and negative 39. I'm hoping that's about the right volume level. Create an ambient. It sounds really horrible because what's going on here is it's playing. It's got a built-in thing where it always. It always plays the same, it can't play the same sound twice within like 0.2 seconds or whatever. I don't know what to think. So I'm going to do the randomness here, like I'll assign which effect to do. So we'll have pitter 1, 2, 3, 4, and patter 1, 2, 3, 4. What happened to the common? So, yeah. Rain one, that's fine. That'll make it way easy. Rain two. And then when we're doing Oh, let's go ahead and create all of these right now, actually. Five, six, seven, eight. There, we got eight of those. Pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter. And these will be two, three, four. Wait, one, two, three, four, five, six. Yeah, there'll be eight of those individually. But for now, we just got the first two. And then when we create the rain, or when the rain bounces, it just does a, you know, a random roll to see which one. Go. All right. So now we should be able to have all multiple of these playing at once. Oh my God, it sounds horrible. Oh, it sounds so bad. All right, we gotta try a totally different sound effect. That was giving me the heebie-jeebies. It was so bad. Trying to imagine what it should sound like. Not that, and not the other thing. Well, the other thing is closer. But no, it's got too much smack. It's got too much smack. It sounds like cement. It's like it's smacking the cement or something. We need something more. This sound, this guy had some good sounds. Maybe this is. It's also indoor. Also the same thing. Yeah, all those have a sound like they're smacking the concrete or something, you know, each drop of rain is just impacting something really flat and hard. Did it sound so bad though? Huh, let me give this another shot. What's up, Red Sands? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Frustrating me not being able to see it, see the spectrum analysis at the same time. This app. This app is. This would be so much better in Ableton, but let's just do that for now. Maybe more. Negative 18. Wow. Yeah. Okay, that's huge. Negative 29, 13. Where in the world will the rain sound be played? All over the place where there's rain. Because in that one area it looks like sand and water, so beach rain. Right, I'm trying to come up with something that sounds kind of universal at first. It sounded really rhythmic to me, and my first thought is that the raindrops might be hitting the ground too uniformly. Yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. I'm already doing the random, yeah, several rain sounds randomly. Yeah. That's what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. Maybe. I don't know. I'm gonna try it though. Okay, so my idea here is to take 8 different sounds, play them all randomly, but my last attempt was to create a single sound for a pitter and a single sound for a patter, and that didn't work so well with the way my engine works. So what I'm going to try now is I'm trying a little bit longer of a clip for each one. So it's not really just a pitter and it's not really just a patter. It's a whole like 0.1 seconds, you know, or so. What is this? This is actually a whole second. Wow. Yeah, so this is kind of going to be experimental because it falls off so fast. You hear that? I don't know what this will sound like, if this will even be anywhere close, but this is the next experiment. Today's rain. Trying to get rain to be procedural. Let's override pitter there. Yes, I am. Yeah, I'm having them play when each rain particle hits the ground. I want each rain particle to be its own entity, and that's how the procedural audio creates itself. But I know what you mean. There's a lot of sounds here to be played, but I think this idea could work. Okay, so let's hear that. Yeah. It's starting to work. Now, if I have eight of those different kind of sound effects, I think this could really actually work. Yes! All right, cool. Rain sounds, version one. So let's apply that same effect to all this. It's before it was really foreground, foreground. That a truck going by? It is, and it kind of sounds cool. Now it's accelerating away. Wow, that's kind of crazy. What about this part? Yeah, just a little, I like this more subtle part right here. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and add in all the sound effects we're gonna need here. I'm just gonna put these in. Pitter patter 2 2 3 3 4 4. Now we need just to create all eight of these. Here's we'll call this pitter 2. That's so crazy because it's got a little bit of that car, that truck or something in the background right there. But I think this actually could create a really neat ambience. Ambience. What? How do you even pronounce that word? Does anybody actually know? Gradient. You hear that, internet? Gradient. That's how you actually pronounce that word. I never knew. 30 years of my life, I always pronounce it. Gradient. Gradient. Wait, I can't. Now I'm confused. Now I'm totally confused. I don't even know which one's which. Screw it. Pattern two. One's pretty neat. It's ambience gradient. Yeah, you did too. Or gradient. No, nobody else pronounced the gradient. Gradient. It's gradient. Yep. But ambience. Is it ambience or ambience? That's kind of really interesting, actually. Okay, call that pitter three. The first one, ambience. Ambience. Yes, this one's pretty good too. Save as pattern three. Yeah. All right, this one's pitter four. We're almost done. Let's try a little. I don't like the beginning of that. Yeah, that's pretty good. Deathstroke, welcome to the stream. Be you human. Let's call that one. Is it patter? Patter four. Yes, we got all eight of them. All right, let's try this out now. Now there's eight sound effects. There's a lot more variation they can put into this whole rain. Yeah. It works. So many of these sound effects playing. There's like so many of these playing that it's like killing the sound engine. I'm making rain, I'm making it pitter patter. Right, if I turn that back, if I turn that off, or maybe play only half as many or something. Let's try half as many. Drand FO1 is like less than 0.5F, so it only plays it like half the time. Oh yeah, it still sounds pretty loud. What's up? Why isn't it playing every sound though? Okay, hold on. It's got me worried. Okay, if I turn off all that sound effect, what happened to the top hat sound? Yeah, totally. Something happened. It killed the other sounds. So maybe less. If I do like way less, let's do an eighth. That still kills it. Why? Why do you kills it? Wait, oh. I think I get it. I think it might be because profile play sound. Oh no, sound play time is based on that file name. But let's just say we were totally ignoring that anyways. Deathstroke, it's already on Steam. Yep, just search for Songbringer on Steam. I'll send you the link. So now we're totally ignoring the fact that the sound play times, so it shouldn't not play a sound effect for any reason. just because something else is already, it thinks something else is already playing. Still, it's not playing the top ad, so it must be a limitation of the sound engine. Oh, wait. So let's put that back to how it was. And I think let's go to the sound engine. Oh, whoa, kit. Oh, it already has the anti-repeat duration in here. And then once again, it uses the sound play times. Doing the same code twice. Okay, let's comment this out now, too. And this one. Jeez, man. We don't need to do that twice. Okay, so now it's going to play it no matter what. Oh, whoa, wait. This is the old sound engine. Jeez, I should just take this out. I'm not going to switch back to this old sound engine. Yeah, it's taking it. Pulling it. Don't need you. Only Fmod. Fmod's pretty awesome. Here's another one I don't need. Two sound engines I don't need. A sound engine for this, for Cocos 2DX is simple sound engine, and then they had another one for their experimental sound engine. Both of them had major problems. But Fmod's pretty awesome. I think I need to get rid of an endif here. There we go. Okay. There. Only one sound engine. That's going to confuse me less in the future. Now, for playing the sound, okay, yeah, does this have any of that anti? It does have the anti-repeat duration for yeah, okay. Let's try it, though. So comment that one out, too. Yeah, so it has nothing to do with the sound play time. It must be where it's initializing the engine and saying, hey, you should have 32 different effects. I bet you did. Yeah, see, it is 32. How many can we do? Max channels. The maximum number of channels to be used in Fmod. These are also called virtual channels, which means that basically they can override each other. As you can play as many of these as you want, even if you only have a small number of real voices. Yeah. Wait, is that? How do you set your real voices then? I don't know, I think this is, it doesn't say anything about what kind of maximum number I can put here. So I'm gonna go ahead and quadruple that. I'm gonna say 128. Let's see what we got now. We have rain and top hat. And the music. Come on. What the hell? Playing like a crap load of sounds? What is going on here? got that initial bit where it plays a whole bunch of sounds. Something's, what is going on? Let's take his probability even lower. I think this code about anti-repeat duration, this should be okay to keep in. So yeah, if you're just joining the stream, what I'm working on here is the sound of rain, and I'm trying to do it procedurally so that it always sounds a little different. Oh, there we go. But we really don't need to do this twice. There we go. Okay, but it's not, it's like, it's playing one. Sometimes it doesn't play the. Oh, let's get it a little bit more chance. So now it's like that. Let's double that. What was that, an 80th? It's not an 80th. So, oh, wow, that is so much more already. All right, that might be the right balance. Still got my cool sounds. I do have a lot of things open right now. I gotta close Ableton. So right between .0125 and .25, found a pretty good, let's try .221. Thank you. that's pretty nice. That gives it a little bit of. A little lulls. Like, so there's slight lulls when you hear. A little bit of random amount of time goes by where you're not hearing the sound effect, and then it creates a little bit of a lull. It's very nice, actually. What's up, Rockabuddy? I'll try a little lower, though. See if we can push that down a bit and see if we get maybe a little more lulls, but not too much lulls. And maybe 16 of these sounds. Yeah, see, it's still pretty good. So how's it going, Rock Bunny? What you working on now, man? Buffering. I was saying, what are you working on now? Let's try a little less of this too. That was pretty good too. Still 0.18 or 0.018. Let's try 0.015. Still sounds good, but when I had it at 0.0125, it sounded too low. Oh yeah, that's definitely too low. So okay, right between 0.015 and 0.012, we've got a pretty big difference. What if we had a 0.013? Maybe that's like just where this one. Oh, I bet that's what it is. Drand F. No. Yeah, that's still sounds like just about exactly the same. So. What is DRAND F is DRAND U, so it's a whole DRAND max, which is a huge ass number. So no, it's not just a precision thing. Unless this is 1/30th of a second or something like that, because we're running this tick that fast or something. I don't know. Let's just go 1/3333. Good enough. Now I want to go and make it so the rain changes per dungeon. So as soon as you beat a dungeon, it either starts raining or it stops raining or changes its weather, basically, whenever you. Thank you. Let's go to the overworld too. Back to Xanadu. Nice. I love how it uses the watercolor of the area. Oh, I'm faster than the rain with the god mode. So I gotta work on the intro to it. It may start off not at a good random positions. Okay, so let's start with getting a good wind angle too. Oh, this is. Where is the waterfall in Xanadu? Oh, here we go. Yeah, that was really good. I like how it faded out really nicely too. This rain is pretty sweet. Okay, I'm gonna check this in so far. This is pretty good. I'm thinking I'm probably gonna double the amount of sound effects and do some other little tweaks to make it even better, but I like the way this is turning out. I'm gonna check kit in separately though. Removing old Cocos Tension based sound engine. See ya. Oh, I'm gonna check this other stuff in too. Except for this this profile thing too. Yeah, let's do that. Profiles don't need those. Sound playtime things. Ah, we could keep that code, they'll comment it out. In case I ever wanted to. Hold on. It's a map. What is that? Oh, that's okay. This is profile's own sound playtime map. Oh, yeah. I guess we should get rid of this completely. This is silly to try and do this same code twice. Sound playtime, see ya! You don't belong here. You belong in the fundamental place, the kit. Okay. So this is also gonna be its own check-in as well. I'm gonna git commit source profile star. So I think the next thing I'm gonna do actually is make it the rain do a ripples when it lands on water. It always takes a long time to compile. When you change something, it changes a lot of files. Which is one of these things, but oh well. Let that index for a minute too while we commit these source profile stars. Just removing sound play times. And I'm gonna run it once to make sure I didn't break anything by doing that. Whoa, I started in God mode. I'm like, why am I on the water? Yeah, I know what I want to do for the other 8 sound effects. I want the same kind of thing, but to have a little more... a little less foreground in it. Even more. Even less, I mean. This is a good example of where this effect kind of breaks. Like when each water droplet lands, it does this. Sometimes it does this little like splash effect, and the splash shouldn't happen on the cliffs. So these cliffs right here. Oh well. Okay, so let's focus on the puddle first. Or I mean the ripple. Oh, whoops. So that's in, not there. Here, each bit of rain. Bounces, there's a chance to do a ripple. And I'm pretty sure that what Ripple does is it goes and checks if it can. Yeah, it does. Smart. Nice. I like functions that are really easy to use like that. Nice. We got ripples. But the ripples are really... dark. What happened to them? They used to be way brighter. Right? Why are you so dark? Let me just make sure that that's even working. Or is that just the little hoppers? Okay, I'm gonna comment out the hoppers for a minute. Only foes. Okay, there we go. Now we got no ripples. Nice, now we got some ripples where they're landing. Now I just gotta make the ripples look good again. Wonder what happened to make them like so bleh. Jeez, what happened to you? Is it the rain itself? Hold on. Commenting out the rain for a minute. Now I guess I gotta turn back on the only, or turn off only foes. Yeah, these ripples are weak. Super weak. All right, Ripples, what happened to you? Why'd you get so dark? Is that opacity? What color are you in the, by the way? Oh, there's no color applied to this. Times opacity? What's up, PMC? What's up, what's up? Think of the first thing that could make us better. Let's try turning off the opacity, see if that makes it better. How you doing today, PMC? Yeah, they're still gray. They're still too... Oh, man. They're bad. They're bad. What about if I use some blend funk on them? Oh, better. It's better for sure. But still not bright enough. Man, I messed up when I made that art. Let's make that art better. I think it's in common ripple. Yeah, ripple one, ripple big. I think it's just ripple one. Wait, what's this? Really? Is this whole document like this? Doing good, working on your pong game? Cool. Oh, you're having problems with the collisions, huh? Really hot, yeah. Oh, you're fasting? Whoa. Nice. Programming to pass the time. Yeah, collision systems can be kind of tricky at first, huh? Getting everything right with the collision systems. But it's worth it once you get it all right, then you can kind of rely on it. You can stop worrying about it and just focus on other parts of your game and stuff if you want. Can't see any of this art. It sure is that big, huh? 60 by 36. Whoa. Okay. All right. So why aren't you all white? You're supposed to be white. Bright white, so we can change you at runtime. Any other color you can't change. White you can change. If you have all your white, you can change it to black. If you have all your white, you can change it to green or whatever. Yeah, see, I drew this in gray. Wait, if I did. Oh, nice, there's opacity. Saving grace, right on. All I gotta do is paint all these white. Oh, that one already is. Are all these already white? Oh, they are. It's just their opacity. Oh, okay, I get it now. I tried to do some opacity here, and which is fine, but I just need to have this thing hit 100%. That's 46, 35, 32. It looks like it's just fading out. 21. 11. Yeah, he's just totally fading out over time. So let's start this off at 100. Oh, using JavaScript. Yeah, definitely good and bad. Yeah. Yes, it is. Yeah. I know what you mean by JavaScript could be much harder than it should be. Oh my God. Yep. JavaScript is that way. So that was 46. If I were to go, that would be 4 times 2 is 8%. So this would be 92. I'll just double all these. 70. Forty-two, good number. 22. I might need to make this end bit a little bit brighter. Okay, so exporting this with all that background off. Now we got a nice white point there. Yo, Boogie! What's up, Boogie? So like folder, what up? Common. Yeah, I think it's here. Ripple. It's called Ripple One. Make sure I don't. Oh, yeah, Ripple One. Render. Okay, now we should have brighter ripples. What? They still don't seem that bright. Oh, because they're additive, maybe. So I'm working on rain today. I got the pitter patter noise working, and now I'm working on the ripples. Oh yeah, that definitely didn't even render this sprite. What the hell happened there? Raw pack. There we go. It's rendering. It's packing that sprite sheet, which was unpacked. I wonder it didn't work. So what I'm working on now is making it so when the rain hits the water, it ripples. And to do that, I had to kind of turn off the rain and focus on the ripples there for a second. So hopefully now they should be brighter and we can see some more beautiful ripples. That's better, but it's still gray. Why are they gray? Get it. Let's double check the basics, just make sure it's white 255. Might be that we're just seeing so much of the the translucent part of it that it's turning it gray. Let's turn down the speed. Yeah, it's totally gray. What's up? Why is it so fugly? Hold on, did it render the right files? Yeah, we just modified all the ripples. Okay. See, this bit right here, it's super white. It's white there. It's still pretty white here. Wait a minute, are we even seeing the beginning of this animation? Yeah, it's there. Oh, it's because it's a reflection sprite. Oh, it's a sprite reflection. That's right. Yeah, we have Fahrenheit. We only have Fahrenheit. That's all we use over here. Nobody knows what Celsius is over here. 20, I'm pretty sure 20 is like around our, or like 30 is like our 90. Yep. Additive kind of helped, I guess. It's a reflection sprite, so reflection sprite. Why is the reflection sprite so? Oh yeah, that's way better. Oh my god. Okay, there. We're in business. All right, I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Yeah, it looks way better too, because it's taking on the color of the water automatically. Very good. Okay, let's just tone it down a tiny bit now. Go back to what its opacity should be. Yeah, we don't know what free meters are or color. Or color. Color? Is that color? Cologne? Cologne is. All right, more. It needs more. 158 was too low. 180 maybe. 188. Oh, it was be rebels even more. Such an American rebel doing 188 instead of 180. It's pushing the envelope. Yeah, that's pretty good. 188. All right, cool. Let's turn the rain back on. Here is the rain. We'll turn it back on. I believe the. Yeah, it does ripple still. Okay, cool. Let's do it. We should see a lot of ripples now. Maybe we should actually put it as more though. Yeah, let's do a ripple every single place where something lands. This might be really overdoing it, but we'll see. Yeah. That's cool. But maybe a little much. I don't know, actually that's a good amount, I think. Yeah, I like it too. It's turning out pretty well so far. See if there's any other rainy areas. Here's one. Still got ripples, even though we got ice. Yeah, the rain's sounding better too, for sure. Yeah, that no, it's not that. I was in God mode. But also that it doesn't start right. So watch when I go to the right, it looks okay. When I go to the left, it doesn't work because it doesn't start falling as, you know, it's like the particles need to be halfway, some of them need to be halfway fallen already. So I just gotta work on that too. But yeah, just trying to work on the ripples first. Oh, there you go, an area with lots of water like that's looking pretty cool. And the anti-repeat duration needs to be longer in the new kit thing I did. Anti-repeat. So let's put that to 1.15. This is how it was in the profile. Definitely adds more atmosphere too. Yeah. And I want to add that's I'm gonna focus on that a lot this week is atmosphere. That's a good theme keyword for this week. Okay, I'm gonna go for 8 more sounds. All 8 of these I want to be I'm gonna play with the EQ on them once more. Actually, let's go straight from the beginning here. Wait, no, not there. No, definitely not that one. Let's just close that entirely. Ah, this one, here we go. Yeah, okay. Let's apply some EQ to this whole thing again and take away more of the, probably the same range. Nope, it's higher. Yeah. 4K. It's like, which one do I want to focus on? Well, I gotta stop it for a second. I gotta get a drink of water. I'll be right back. I need to clear my head a second. It helps when you're making sound effects to clear your head as often as possible, because what you're hearing the same. If you hear the same thing over and over and over and over and over, you get used to it, and then you don't sense the nuances and stuff. So, breaks help. Okay, so my choice was which kilohertz band to focus on erasing here. And if I take it all the way up 10K. Ooh, definitely not. Okay, yeah, it's the 4K for sure. Maybe the 5K too. Time lapses for sure. Well, cool. Oh, you went to Yosemite? This is my favorite place on Earth. Hey, is this what? Wait, what mountain's that? Oh, you were in the Bay Area? I live around here. Pike Peak? Really? Pike's Peak? Sweet. Dude, this is a cool video. Yeah, totally. I gotta mute it though, in case it's copyrighted. Is it copyrighted music? Oh, Yosemite is my favorite place. Oh, is that Yosemite Falls? Or no, that's the other one on the other side. What's Tuolumne? No. Yeah, Yosemite for sure. Bridal Veil Falls, that's it. Bridal Veil. Oh, you went to Utah? Yeah, I love this place too. Zion, this is Zion or is it Bryce? God, the snow one? That's awesome. It's Sedona. Oh, Sedona. Cool, man. That's awesome. Thank you for sharing. That's really cool. Really cool. It's some of my favorite places there. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Reminds me of the, like, you know, all the good times I've had there and those kind of places too. Next time you're in the Bay Area too, you should say hi. We'd go grab a beer or something. Last time, who was in town recently? Oh, Vlad was in town from Israel. So we got together, we had some pizza and some beer. And then I met Mars of Power last year. That was fun. Okay, Yeah, I do want to take out the 10K as well. Yeah, okay, there we go. This is taking out a lot of the pitter, the high end of the splashy pitter patteriness. I'm taking that clean out so that I have eight sound effects that have more of the high end and eight sound effects more the low end. Yeah, I imagine you probably didn't have much time. Yep. Let's go for maybe the end of it. This is nice and pretty uniform here. Get about a second. And let's hook up all these sound effects too, so they're ready to go. Rain, 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 rain. Rain 9, rain 10, 11, 12, all the way up to 16. And this is going to be pitter, patter, Five, six, seven, eight. Make sure these are right. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8, 8. Cool. Now let's make them. Little log fade in, log fade out. This one is Pitter 5. Shazam! Interesting effect going on in this one. I like it. How does one distinguish the difference between a pitter and a patter? I don't know. I would think that the patter has a little more high end. And by high end, I mean like above 1K, 1 kilohertz. Interesting. This one almost sounds like a railroad. It's a railroad of its own. Patter 5. Shazam! Fair enough, yeah? What about you? You got any theories on the matter? How should we delineate? So I'm just making sure each one of these selections is its own little good loop, and then I'm totally unlooping it so we can create some procedural audio. It's weird that this technique worked, but it did. This one's a pitter 6. You're cool with that theory? Oh yeah. Cool. All right, Boogie and I have just established the international classification for the difference between a pitter and a patter. Yep, this is spec version 1.0. And for now, we're just saying in version 1.0 that above 1K is a patter and equal to or below 1K is pitter. Yep. All y'all non-standards rebels out there, you can eat it. We've got a standard. All right. That's a six. Patter 6, I think. Boom. Boom. That's right. That's so boomy, I don't even have to say boom like loudly. Just boom. Copy to new. Stop playing. There we go. Mic drop. Pitter 7. Cool. That loops. Now unloop it. PMC won the free parking? Oh my god, PMC, your day just changed, man. Congratulations. Okay, I'm gonna give him some more points to see if he's here. Oh, he's here. He's here. What are we at? Pitter seven? Or did I already do pitter seven? Piter. Pitter. Oh, I did pitter seven. What about patter seven? Lost count. Patter seven, done. All right, two more. I like this little bit right there. Let's see if that sounds good. See, he's really here. It's like a slap at the beginning, but it still sounds loop enough. Loopity doopity. Now your life is totally changed. This one needs a little more fade. That was the way money works. Think we could all mutually agree that that would be a pretty remarkable thing. You never have to worry where your next PB&J will come from. Ever. Ever again. I like the patterns in this one. This one's definitely a patter right here. Guys hear that patter at the beginning? Patter eight. All right, we got 16 sounds now. This is super duper procedural rain sound. Oh, but we're still using the old ones. I'm like, why does it still sound like the old one? Why? Because we haven't done enough of these. We gotta do this. Gotta do 16. So much better. Oh. So the focus that time, if anybody was paying attention, was basically that what's is it some of the sounds have half of the pitter-patter sounds have like a higher end, and half of the pitter-patter sounds don't. So it adds a really nice balance. Okay, so next up, I'm gonna focus on fixing the bug where when I move from one area to another, the rain doesn't start right. It starts really wrong, actually. And a lot of things hit the ground. It's like, yeah, just focusing on the start of it. Or should I make it? No, that's kind of one of the last things I'll work on. Yeah. I'm not going to focus on the start of it just yet. I'm going to focus on that later because it's going to be kind of buggy. So, what I'm going to do now is make it so when you go in, idea, don't create birds when it's raining. They're hiding in the trees. Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah. Okay, so yeah, that's a good segue into the what I wanted to code right here anyways because I want to work on the part where it's like chooses whether the game should be, the game thinks, oh, should it be raining right now? You know? What type of weather should it be right now? Sunny, rainy, snowy? That's gonna be all based on how many bosses you beat in the current world. So based on the world seed, that's your random number start, that will determine the order of the weather that will play. And it change your the weather changes every time you come back from a dungeon having defeated it. So or having, you know, been victorious. So you beat a boss, you come back to the overworld, and it's now a different kind of weather. Open source Game Boy-like console computer. You don't say that every day. It's extension. Wow, that's cool. Nice. Me type it out. I gotta check it out. Open source Game Boy like console computer. Pocket chip, huh? Ads.
Portable computer, and it turned out it's the chip computer. Hey, Dave, how you doing? Excellent, excellent. So last year you guys introduced the chip computer. You guys started shipping it. It's a nine.
Chip pewter? Is that what it's called? The chip pewter?
It's a pretty amazing computer for $9. It's got a 1 gigahertz processor, 512 megs of RAM, 4 gigs of storage, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, battery power, and charging. And
What? That's a $9 computer?
Storage, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth,
Oh,
battery.
wait, how much RAM did it have?
It's a pretty amazing computer for $9. It's got a 1 gigahertz processor, 512 megs of RAM, 4 gigs of storage, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, battery power, and charging.
How much storage?
Amazing computer for $9. It's got a 1 gigahertz processor, 512 megs of RAM, 4 gigs of storage, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth,
4
battery
gigs?
power, and charging. And it's completely open source and it runs Linux. Right, and you guys started shipping. I've been doing firmware update.
Tits, that's pretty rad. Wow. It makes me want one, but I don't know what I'd do with one. Know? What? I guess I'd run Linux on it. I'd be like, sweet, here's my Linux distro right here. Bam. My $9 Linux distro. I'd be like, elementary OS, here I come. Oh, wait. Okay, so the game's gonna decide what type of weather it should have. I'm gonna add, let's check in what we got so far. Get status, get add. The patters and the pitters. Okay, and now I'm probably gonna be done with the rain, but okay, so weather types. Gonna add a constant for that, an enum weather type constant. And the gargoyle. Yes, what's up, and the gargoyle? I know, when was that? When was that? Do you remember what day it was when it was in its wee infancy? I remember those days. It was what cute days, its wee little infancy. So we're gonna have K weather sunny, K weather rainy light. Rainy heavy. About Misty. Snowy. That's enough of those for now. Tornado? We need a tornado, though. Really, all I wanted to do was just maybe put two of those for now, like sunny and rainy. But I'm just gonna put a few because, like, I can't do it, so why not, you know? Because the rain's like all got parameters, and I can easily change the parameters to make different kinds of rain. So. All right, so the game needs to be able to determine what type of weather it should have at that current moment. And I guess that should be the world depending on your bosses. Yeah, so okay, so that should be a world thing. So world dot h. We're gonna call just get weather type, and it's based on your boss statuses. So get bosses, set bosses, get boss. There we go. Static weather type, get weather type. SimCity 2000 Alien Invasion. We need that. The tornado from that, is that what you're talking about? Or do we need the alien invasion, the actual alien invasion from that one? That's a weather type. The weather is currently that the aliens are invading. God damn, it's taking forever to compile today. Probably because I just changed constants. Okay, but let's write this. Let's write this while it's compiling. Set bosses, set bosses, get boss status. Actually, this should be more up here. Okay, so based on we need a random number, but it's deterministic. So we'll base that on. Area 0, 0, 0. So good. Oh no. I love those sound effects. Oh no, the tornado! Otherwise, just like blah, 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 blah. Oh no, that's the alien. I forgot about the alien invasion one. Yeah, that'd be a good game to play, right? Play again? Classic. Such classic. I love how it's like. Bzz, there's so much stuff being destroyed now. It's just like. Bzz, blah. You had a basic procedural dungeon generator? Awesome! Love how fast the sound effect's going now. All right, so now we got a random number that's deterministic based on the very first area, and then we also got the boss count of the bosses that have been defeated. So will the weather type? I feel like it should never start with snow. But why not? Yeah, let's just try a straight up randomness at first. Okay, so we'll just return weather type R plus boss count. Oh, we need a number of web. Damn it, I gotta go change constants again. We need a number of weather types. I think it's gonna be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and there's 5 of these. So this is K weather snowy plus 1. Right, so this is all mod K num weather types. Okay. Let's see what we got. And then based on the weather type, we can do rain or sunny or snowy as long as it's outdoors. It does. It does. If you put the number in the enum though. So I would have had to redesign that enum to be, to have a built-in number total. And that's kind of not how I wanted it. I wanted that enum to start from 0. So, oh wait, no. No wait, I could actually put knum weather types at the end. That would have worked perfect if I put knum weather types at the end of the enum. Right? I would just put it there. And that would technically work, but then what that would do is it would make a weather type. Technically, that would make a weather type available that's knum weather types. Which really isn't what I want to do eventually. So this is kind of more accurate from a programmer perspective. It's like, okay, now I've got these exact weather types, and then yeah, so I guess it is not really Yeah, C++ could be better in a lot of ways. I can't wait for Jai. Come on, Jonathan Blow. Give us Jai. I want to write my next game in Jai. But I'm definitely not going to convert these 60,000 lines of code. God, we're probably above 60,000 now. What is it now? 65,000. Every time I look at it, it's bigger. It's not exactly a good thing. All that code to maintain. Okay, but anyways, it's almost done compiling. You get the weather type in an area. Hold on, let's put a breakpoint here so I got this. I can turn this thing open and I got like, oh yeah, look at all these places. All right, so based on the weather type, just to spawn in disasters and reduce the population to zero. Isn't that the goal of the game? I don't remember. Maybe. Right, so if we're not sunny, we're gonna do rain. The sidewaysness, this is negative one to one, and I want this to be based on the wind vector. There's a wind vector. In, I think it's in game. Get wind vector, yeah. And what does this change? Y is zero, X is something. Okay, yeah, so that just gives us a negative one or one X based on the time of day. But I wanted that to be kind of based on. This could be better. Wait, no, there is, it is better. I know I did it this really well actually in. Title scene? Title layer? Winbeck. Oh my God. Who knew that wind vector is only one or negative one, and it could be so much better based on the hour of day, closer it is to afternoon, for example, the wind vector could give. I thought I wrote that though. I thought I wrote something where in the afternoon there was more wind. This is the actual afternoon for people, us players. If the game detects that it's afternoon for you, then it would be more windy. Oh well, we'll just use the negative one and one for now. So we got the wind vector. The sidewaysness is something times the sine. Of the wind vector. So if we're heavy rain, Sidewaysness based on the wind vector x. Let's assign that. And now sidewaysness is going to be something misty. Rand F 01 times 0.2 maybe. Speed really slow when it's misty. Let's go 0.5 maybe. Density also pretty soft. So let's go 0.5. So there's misty. All right, so we'll go rainy and all that. Rainy light, rainy heavy. Let's make all this zero actually, and then go if luminosity is greater than zero, we'll do some rain. Okay, so light rain is gonna be pretty light itself in its luminosity. Heavy rain is gonna be darker in its luminosity. Sidewaysness of light rain is more like 0.25 plus drand f 01 times maybe 0.5. And then speed 0.75 maybe. Or one, let's put all the way to one. Density, also one. And then heavy rain, the sidewaysness goes way up. It's more like 0.5F, no, more like 0.75 plus 0.25. Heavy rain's pretty fast and dense too. Okay, let's see that. Let's get surprised too. I don't know what kind of weather this will be at first. Might be snowy, and then it would just be sunny basically. Oh, looks like we have a light rain, but that's too slow. I think that's light rain. Someone stop the itching. Has it been 2 hours, Bafu? It probably has. The randomness of that needs to be based on its density. Yeah, it probably needs different sound effects too, dang. Okay. Let's just manually set the weather types for a minute. Let's try these out. Weather type equals K, weather sunny. Oh, you know what? This needs to all be wrapped if outdoorness. Dang, this needs to be if outdoorness is greater than zero. Yep, there's sunny. Misty. Isn't outdoors pretty binary? No, it's not. It's not actually. What if you had an area that had big old windows in it, right? This I was actually designing this for the ship Songbringer. There's gonna be one area on Songbringer where you can see outside. So it's like halfway outside, right? You're letting in some of the light from outside. It was more of a light thing. Yes, right. The word outdoorness isn't. This is basically just light. I was thinking about light. So you can let some of the outdoor lightness come in. But yeah, it is pretty funny. So basically, all the indoor areas, though, they're all at zero. So they're either zero or they're above it. So at this point, we're treating it binary. All right, Misty. Misty. Way too slow. So 1.0 is slow. This should be at least 1.5. This one should be at least 1.0. And then, oh, this needs to, the length of these rain particles needs to be smaller too. So if it's like a misty rain, it's a shorter raindrop. I guess that could just be based on speed. That's even a little bit slow. Ooh, I am getting hungry though. Man, I gotta get going soon. Like all of a sudden got like a pang of hunger. Hunger pangs. That's better. I think that's about the slowest rain right there. 1.25 speed works pretty well there. Yeah, so that's it for today's stream. I'll keep playing with this weather some more. I'll work on the misty type, the rainy light type, the rainy heavy type, and snow. There'll even be a light snow, I'm thinking, not like a heavy snow. But yeah, so anyways, I had fun chatting with y'all and hope you all have a great night. Cheers.